That was one of the most interesting ecosystem of the world before the 60s. The area now for the one third is now a desertic area, where of course biodiversity doesn't exist anymore and most of the species have disappeared. Water from the two rivers was taken by engineering work, building dikes, building channels that of course also changed the morphology of the area. Have a sort of pumping that is so extreme. The level of the lake decreased of 17 meters. So birds and many other species of animals due to the hypersalinization of the lake, but not only. The increase of the desert created the sandstorms. These of course create a climate and a situation that doesn't allow the species living in the area to continue to survive. There was an increasing of poverty due to lack of water access and water security. It was an economic disaster. That pesticides and fertilizers infiltrate in the subsoil and then reach the aquifers, the groundwater resources. And of course, drinking water is mainly derived by wells that are pumping in these aquifers. Thank you. In Kazakhstan, the level of the lakes has increased and some of the species are back. But at the same time, this dam doesn't allow the flow of the water to reach the southern part of the Aral Sea. The two rivers, the Sir Daria and the Amu Darya rivers, that take their source from the Hindu Kush and the Pamir, before to reach Uzbekistan and Kazakhstan, they go through Afghanistan, Kyrgyzstan and Tajikistan. The problem is much more than only Uzbekistan and Kazakhstan management of the water. It's a really a regional coordination and cooperation for the management of transboundary waters of the region. Without a real sustainable management and governance of water resources, and in particular, the protections of the glaciers, looking at the impact that climate change, definitely there will be no much future for the Aral Sea in the next 100 years.